जय हिंद एवरीवन. नाउ लेट अस डू द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, हाउ टू टेल वाइल्ड एनिमल्स. एंड लेट्स सी द क्वेश्चंस. द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज दिस, डज डाइन रियली मीन रियली राइम विद लायन? कैन यू से इट इन सच अ वे दैट इट डज? एक्चुअली इफ यू सी अबाउट दिस वर्ड डाइन, द एक्चुअल वर्ड इज डाइंग, नॉट डाइंग. बट डाइंग, सिंस डाइंग डज नॉट राइम एट ऑल विद लायन, so therefore the narrator has actually made it dine, so that it actually rhymes a little bit with lion, so that there is a little bit of rhyming length pattern in these two words. And though actually it does not rhyme, but it actually looks like it is rhyming. So here you can say it in a manner like dine, lion, so in that manner. Either dine, line is like this. If you pronouncing, then perhaps it may rhyme a little bit. So this is the answer of this question. How does the poet suggest that you identify the lion and the tiger? When can you do according to him? So about lions, he suggests that if you are visiting east, then someday if you have actually spotted an animal which roars loudly, and after hearing the roar, what do you do? You start dying. That means suddenly you feel like you are going to die, and then at that time you must know that you have spotted a lion. And about tigers, he has said that if you spot an animal on a yellow background, there are black stripes, then and that animal starts eating you, then suddenly you get to know that it is a Bengal tiger or it is a tiger. When can you do so according to him? So these are the two things that he has suggested, that you can identify a lion and a tiger. Do you think the words leapt and leap in the third stanza are spelt correctly? No, the actual word, this actual spelling of this word leapt is L-E-A-P-T, and this one L-E-P is L-E-A-P. And actually this is misspelled. And why has he actually used misspelled word in the poem? So that actually it makes a little bit of rhyming with the other words given in the stanza. So it is just for the rhyming and creating a sound effect, rhyming sound effect in the poem. Do you know what a bear hug is? It is a friendly and strong hug such as bears are thought to give as they attack you again. Hyenas are thought to laugh and crocodiles to weep as they swallow their victims. Are there similar expressions and popular ideas about wild animals in your own language? So if you talk about then definitely you'll find out so many, like if you talk to your elders, you'll find out so many things about several other animals. And here if you talk about bear hug is means what? Somebody when you actually gives a very tight hug, that is called what a bear hug. And if you talk about hyenas, they actually do not laugh, but their faces are like that only. So that is why she has used over here that the hyenas appear to be laughing, and crocodiles do not actually weep. When they swallow their prey or hunt, at that time they suddenly tears start coming down from their eyes, and that is why it is actually, she has described that crocodile tears. And even like you must have heard a famous saying that crocodile, somebody is crying with crocodile tears. So a crocodile tears means what? The crocodile is actually eating the prey, and at the same time he is crying also. So that is what known as crocodile tear, and that is why she has described over here crocodile. If you find a crocodile in tears, if you find an animal in tears, you will find out that it is a crocodile. If you find out it is laughing, then it is a hyena. And look at the line, no wise might nonplus. Here you see this one, this line, a no wise might nonplus. What does it mean actually? No wise means what? Somebody who is new to something, new to a job. And nonplus means what? Confused. So how would you write this correctly? If I had to write this correctly, actually this whole sentence is not correct. A no wise might nonplus. A no wise might be nonplussed. This should be the correct sentence. But why is the poet incorrect line? Why is the poet's incorrect line better in the poem? So again, it is just to create a rhyming pattern, a musical effect in the poem. and that is where she has used it incorrectly. Because if you use it like that only, our no voice might be nonplussed. You'll find out that it doesn't look poetic. So that is why she has used over here the incorrect sentence. And a lot of poets do it to actually create a musical effect in their poem. They just do it. They just write it in a manner that even sometimes their sentences are incorrect. Even sometimes the spelling is misspelled. So these are the things the poets keep on doing. Can you find out other examples of poets talking, taking liberties at language, either in English or in your own language? Can you find examples of humorous poems in your own language? So there are so many examples where poets actually do something. I remember one example from the poem The Ancient Mariner. And in that, the poet has used the word kirk, K-I-R-K. That was just to describe a church. So there are so many things that poets do. Much of the on humor in the poem arises from the way language is used. Although the ideas are funny as well, if there are particular lines in the poem that you especially like, share these with the class. Speaking briefly about what is it about the ideas or the language that you like or find funny. So this is totally your answer. This whole thing, that means this is asking you that what all things did you find in the poem very funny, and just share it with the whole class. So this is totally your answer. What is the thing that you found funny in the poem? So you are going to write about that thing only. So this is the thing. Now what you have to do in your homework. So there is one PDF that I have shared of the question and answer PDF. In that one, you will find at the end this kind of thing. Self-assessment test, you will find out. Fine? At the end, what are you going to find out? A self-assessment test. So, you are going to do this one, a self-assessment test in your copy, as well as these NCERT questions that we have discussed right now. So, this self-assessment test must be done in your copy and sent to me at 4 o'clock today in the evening. Fine? In the WhatsApp group. So this is your homework, as well as you are going to write all the NCERT questions in your copy. Thank you, everyone.